Hey guys, TommyBryson here, and today I'm going to tell you exactly how do you keep more money in your pocket. And by the way, the average person might make $30,000 or, for example, $50,000 every single year, but in reality, they still have an issue when it comes to keeping that money in their pocket. And by the way, this video is about telling the truth, not to me, but basically to yourself. So I'll start first, okay? When I was 19 years old, I hit rock bottom, meaning I fell as low as I possibly could when it came to my money problems. Meaning, I was 19 years old, I was making around 60 bucks every single week, and I had around 2K in credit card debt and around $13,000 in student loan debt. And you might say, Tommy, well, you dug yourself into a hole you can't get out of. However, I dug that hole while things were going great in my life, okay? I was making around $2,000, a little bit more, a little bit less. Some months were really good, some months were really bad, whatever. But I was making a decent amount of money. And during those days, that's when I went ahead and took out all that debt, got the credit card stuff, and I started just spending money left and right, buying whatever I actually wanted. And when things went wrong, that's when I hit rock bottom. It's not like I hit rock bottom and I stayed there, but no, I hit rock bottom. And that's when I realized that, hey, I have a problem and I need to fix this. So today, I'll tell you exactly how I went from being that kid at 19 years old to now saving and investing more than 95% of my money every single time I get paid. A big difference, okay? And the whole idea is, well, if you make a lot of money or not a lot, how are you supposed to keep more of this money in your pocket? And today, I'll tell you exactly how to do that. Now, if you guys are new here, I post videos every single day, so you should also subscribe and hit the bell to get notified, and on top of that, also destroy the like button. Now, the very first thing, guys, is this, okay? Everything in life is step by step. You don't wake up one day and you're 100K in debt, and all of a sudden you're living paycheck to paycheck. No, usually it happens step by step. You get one credit card, you get your student loan debt, you get a car loan, you get a mortgage, or you're paying crazy rent, whatever it is, right? But step by step, your money keeps dwindling. And before you know it, you're living paycheck to paycheck and you don't know what to do. The same thing goes, for example, with diet, right? You eat a little bit more, you don't exercise, and before you know it, 3 years later, now you're overweight by 30 pounds and you don't know how it happened. The answer is, it happens in increments. It happens step by step. And the point is, I want to show you exactly what is wrong with what you're doing. That way, you can face it and basically fix those issues and before it actually gets a lot worse, okay? Because you never know what's gonna happen. Things can get worse than you actually think they can actually get, okay? So now what you're going to need to do, guys, is basically you're going to have to create a budget. A budget is going to be your GPS to where you're actually heading. If you don't have a budget, it's impossible to fix your problem because basically you don't know what the problems actually are. So what you wanna do is basically list all of your incomes and then basically all of your expenses and find out exactly where your money is actually going. In my case, when I did this, my money was going towards clothes, sneakers, Chipotle, ice cream, just buying straight nonsense, okay? But for you, I recommend you go on your phone and check your statements. That way you know exactly where your money is actually heading. So step one, make a budget. How do you do this? You wanna draw a T column. Remember, for example, like I'm back in high school, or if you're in high school, whatever it is, the answer is on one side, put your income, the other side, put your expenses, and you wanna list all of your expenses and all of your income. Usually it's gonna be one or two incomes, okay? Then you wanna add them up, okay? So your incomes might be, for example, 3,000, expenses might be, for example, 2,000 or whatever it is, right? And then what you wanna do is subtract it. So if I make $3,000 in income, right? And then minus my expenses of $2,000, well, in reality, that means I have an extra $1,000. But for a lot of people, they might be spending way more than they actually make. And that is going to be a massive issue, a massive problem. However, we are going to fix it. The whole goal is to find out exactly what the problem is, so then we go ahead and fix it, okay? So once you find this out, I want you to circle all the expenses that you don't need to have in your life. If you don't need it, get rid of it. You don't need to have Apple Music and Spotify and Netflix all at the same time. The answer is no. Get rid of everything. The goal is to fix the hole you dug. This way, we can actually get out of that hole and actually see the light of day. That's the entire goal here. So everything you don't need, take it off. Take it off, take it off, take it off. Cancel everything you don't need. That way, you have a lot more income to play around with to do what we need to do next. On top of that, there is one more thing I also want you to do that involves math. And that's basically calculating exactly what your net worth actually is. You know, like Warren Buffett like has a $90 billion net worth. Well, we're going to find out exactly what your net worth actually is. And the way we do that is by basically, you have your assets, the things you actually own, debt-free, and then you want to minus it from your liabilities, okay? And that's going to equal your net worth, okay? And liabilities are basically, hey, what do I owe money on? For example, I have a car, so I owe money on that. I have credit card debt. I have a personal loan debt. I have student loan debt. I have a mortgage. All this stuff are just liabilities. So usually, say for example, again, guys, okay, let's use a calculator here. If you have $10,000 in assets, maybe like you actually have a car that you actually own. You might have, for example, equipment, whatever it is, right? And you want to minus it from your liabilities, all of your loans, all of your debts, everything you owe money on, right? Things you actually don't own. Okay, minus maybe like $50,000, you might be having a net worth that's actually negative. Maybe negative 40K, negative 20K, negative 10K, negative $100, whatever it is. If you're actually in the positive, then great. But if you're not, again, do not feel bad. The goal is to know exactly where we are so then we can go ahead and fix it. So now we know your budget, right? Your income, your expenses, how much money you have left over. That's basically like your cash flow in a way. On top of that, we also know your net worth, which is awesome. But now we need a financial plan to go ahead and fix all this stuff. Now, the plan I use is called Financial Freedom Steps. And by the way, when you have expenses, the goal is to have your expenses as low as 70% or maybe lower to 50% if you actually want to be very frugal and save a ton of money. So your expenses should not be more than 70% of your income. That's the whole goal. This way you can save a lot more money. Now, by the way, this might mean, hey, I gotta move from where I live because basically it's too expensive. Now, here's the entire plan that we actually want to take action on. Now, the first step is going to be you want to get rid of all the debt you actually have. It's no investing, none of that stuff. No, the answer is we want to get rid of all the debt we have while also building concrete habits. How do you do this? The answer is we want to focus on six accounts. The first one is emergencies. So when things go wrong, we have money there and don't need to go into credit card debt or personal debt. So you want to save $1,000 before you start this plan. On top of that, you want to have that money separate in another account. And you also, every time you get paid, you want to send over there 1% of your income. Do this automatically by putting on, for example, auto transfers on that account. So when I get paid, for example, $1,000, I want to send over, for example, just 10 bucks to an account, 1%, just to build a habit of saving money for emergencies. On top of that, investments, okay? Investments are important, but right now the priority is going to be on paying off the debt because basically, debt is going to be costing you a lot more money and we want to get rid of it. Everything except the mortgage, that's all, including student loan debt. We're going to get rid of that. And account number two is going to be investments. Now, this can be, for example, into a Roth IRA, 401k, or for example, a taxable account. It doesn't really matter. But what you want to do is start investing 1% of your income, that's all, and put it to do it automatically. This way, we also build the habit and the system to have your money automatically invested. But Tommy, it's only 1%. The answer is yes. We're only interested in building the habit. The first step overall is going to be to pay off debts and build habits. Investing is a good habit, but our priority is not an investing right now. By the way, I have a portfolio down below if you want to copy it exactly with M1 Finance. Now, the third account is going to be our debt account. Now, we want to pay between 26 to 46% of all our money towards debt, meaning we want to get out of debt as fast as possible using the avalanche method. Meaning, for example, paying the debt with the highest APR first and paying the minimum on all the other accounts, okay? So if I have a credit card, that's 90%, pay that credit card off first and work yourself down and down and down, paying the highest APR debt. This way, we save a lot more money mathematically. And the fourth account, guys, is going to be expenses. Obviously, expenses, you want to keep between 50% to 70%. This way, you're not spending all your money and you have enough money to do this entire plan. But again, this might mean I gotta move, I gotta sell something. That's the whole idea. Everything you don't need, sell it, get rid of it, okay? Sell everything. That's the whole point here. On top of that, fun. You wanna take around 1% of your money and use it towards having fun. Why? So it can remind you that your money can be used for that and you can actually enjoy a little bit of it. But again, priority here is basically paying off debt. The sixth account and the last one is going to be charity. Just 1% going to your favorite charity and doing it also automatically. This way, it changes the type of person you actually are at a very deep level. Charity is very, very important. But that's it, guys, okay? First step is you want to pay off all your debts. Well, you say, for example, 1K. The second step is basically building a foundation, meaning you want to save after you're debt-free 3 to 6 months of emergencies, and that way, when things go wrong again, eventually, you will have enough money to take care of things no matter what. And also, you want to invest between 15 to 25% of your money into that portfolio you already been investing money into. Usually, it's going to be your 401k match with the company first, then, for example, max your Roth IRA, and then, if you have any money left over, into a taxable normal account. That's the idea. So once you're done with this, you have, for example, a foundation. You have emergency accounts, and you also start investing. Now, the third step is going to be lowering your expenses. Now that you have, for example, no debt and also emergencies covered, the answer is you want to go ahead and grab all the extra money you actually have and put it towards saving money for a down payment while you're still investing your money and keeping your expenses low. The goal here is to go out there and buy a house following the 33% rule, meaning this house cannot exceed 33% of your monthly income, including, for example, all the expenses, including taxes, insurance, maintenance, HOA fee, everything. And then you want to go ahead and get it also on a 15-year mortgage. This way, you limit the amount of house you can actually buy, and you buy a house that's decent enough, right? But not too expensive, okay? And you want to put it on a 15-year mortgage, because basically, this way, you're going to be done a lot faster. Once you buy that house, right, it's a part of your expenses, which means you're going to have extra money. That extra money should be going towards a mortgage. Usually, it's going to be around 15% of your income. Put that money towards a mortgage extra. That way, you're done a lot faster than 15 years. And by the way, while you're doing this, you also want to be investing between 15 to 25% of your money. This way, when you're done with that, you also have a hefty, bulky investment account. And once you're done with that, guys, the last step is just autopilot. Meaning, hey, I'm debt-free. I have an emergency account. I have a home I actually own, and now all I want to do is keep investing and basically enjoy my money a lot more. So now, fund can go up to 10, 20, 30%. On top of that, for example, charity can go up to 10, 20% also. The idea is now you can go out there, have more fun, and for example, give a lot more money. But overall, that's the full financial plan. But the first step is going to be getting out of debt, building a foundation, lowering your expenses by buying a house, and lastly, getting everything on autopilot. That's the entire goal. And by the way, guys, I am working on a full-blown course going through every single detail. But for now, you get everything for free. And that is basically it, guys. Hopefully, this helps you keep more money in your pocket. It does not matter how much money you make. Only matters how much money you keep. Whether you have 20K or 30K in income, does not matter. The idea is you practice this and you will become wealthier step by step. That's the overall goal. Guys, see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. As always, like, subscribe, hit the bell so you're notified. Comment down below any questions. If you guys like this video right here, well, like this video on top. But also, subscribe, hit the bell so you're notified. If you guys want to text me or talk to me one-on-one, join my Patreon, link down below, or send me a DM on Instagram at TommyBryson. And before I go, if you want to watch another video, well, here's a video right here, and click my face right here. See you guys next time. And as always, peace.